All attendees are in listen-only mode.
Welcome, everyone. This is the new rescheduled presentation of Gil Raviv's presentation of Power Query and Facebook Insights. Welcome, everybody, to this session. First of all, some community news. Every year, elections are being held for the past board of directors, and in 2016, the Global Past membership will vote on three seats, two open, and one which is, two which are regional, which is the US and Canada and LATAM, and the third seat is an open seat with no regional jurisdictions. The elections are critical to ensure that past members have a voice in leadership and direction of past. So all members of PASS must have completed an update of your MyPASS profile by June the 1st to be eligible. And voting is completely private and anonymous, so feel free to update your PASS profile and join in on voting to make sure your candidate is elected. And the elections will take place in September, and in the process from June 1st until September, there will be several updates with election campaigns and voting process and so on. Also, coming up in a very short time, you have the PASS Business Analytics Conference in San Jose, May the 2nd to May the 4th. And there are some great speakers coming in. You have keynote speaker Jer Thorpe, who is a renowned data artist and educator. And there are some really, really good speakers coming in for Power BI, Excel, Big Data, Predictive Analytics, and so on. So it's really worth your time if you have the chance to attend. And you can go to passbaconference.com to attend, or to register, sorry. Also, there are so many different virtual chapters, where Excel BI is one of them, with the meetings, not every day, but every week there is at least one chapter that has a presentation of some sort with lots and lots of free education. You can also find different chapters on YouTube channels where the recorded webinars are being hosted. This chapter deck was created so early that I don't have any list of the upcoming chapter meetings, but just go into sqlpass.org/events and you can find them there. Also, you have upcoming SQL Saturdays coming, and SQL Saturdays are one-day free training events, which is, I mean, it's completely free. You can just pay for your lunch if you want to, with lots of high-quality education there as well. The first one coming up there is in Costa Rica on April 23rd. Then you have the Baltimore BI edition on April 30th. And then May 7th on Jacksonville. You have Rochester and Houston on May 14th. And May 21st you have in Atlanta and in Kiev. And then also in El Salvador. So lots and lots coming up. And sqlsaturday.com to find an event near you and register there. PASS wouldn't exist without its global network of passionate, dedicated, and hardworking volunteers. So if you feel you have the energy to contribute to the community, please register. Go in for and look for local opportunities on volunteer.sqlpass.org. And you can also update your My Volunteering section of your My PASS profile to register for PASS HQ-related activities such as abstract review committees for a summit and so on. And volunteering for PASS is a really great opportunity to connect with other people and also contribute. It's really nice. So to continue on to the next session, I've first got a few polls for you. Let's start with this one. What is your level of expertise with Power Query? Give you a few moments to fill in. Okay, seems so far that we have more than 50% are basic power query users. You have, and then the 50-50 split between moderate practitioners of power query and I've heard about it but never used it. Okay, coming into the next one. Are you familiar with the Facebook Graph API? And the vast majority says no. There's a couple of who says yes, and some 23-24% who says to some extent. Okay, and then we go to the next one. Do you perform analysis of Facebook pages as part of your job? And it seems like close to 96% so far says no. So it's a good thing you are here today. I hope you'll learn a lot from Gil. Starting to hand things over to Gil. I'll just have to find him here. Gil being former Microsoft Excel Project Manager, and now he's moved to the US and started as a blogger. He's got really great knowledge of the Excel Power Tools. So thank you again, Gil, for taking your time here to present for us.
Thank you, John, and hi, everyone. I will just share my screen and we'll begin in a minute.
While we're waiting for that, just if anybody have any questions during the talk, just present them, and I'll stop Gil from time to time to ask the questions, okay?
Sure. So can you see my screen at this stage?
Yes.
Excellent. So hi, everyone. My name is Gil Raviv. I'm also a blogger at datachant.com. Today we are going to see how to use Excel to create really powerful dashboard and reporting solution for Facebook information. The main scenarios are whenever you need to analyze your users' engagement on Facebook, whether you manage your company brands on Facebook, or whether you want to see also how your competitors or partners are doing, and to get some insights in comparison to your own audience on Facebook brand. So just before we start, a very short slide about myself. For the last 2 years, I was a senior program manager in the core Excel team and was responsible with many other people to get all the BI functionality in Excel into a better stage in Excel 2016. One of my own specific responsibilities, and perhaps some of you may know me through this activity, was the integration of Power Query into Excel 2016. Today's we will show demos, and only demos. I will try not to talk about theory or to push and sell all kinds of features in Excel. We will just show you the demos so you will be able to follow later on step by step to be able to recreate the same reporting that we have done through this demo. Before we start, just a very short disclaimer. I'm using in this demo Excel 2016, but you can also achieve everything that we will do today with Excel 2010 and Excel 2013 if you have the latest Power Query add-in. Okay. And of course, everything that you will see today is already mentioned in my blog, so you can also follow some of the scenarios there, and you can try also to contact me through Twitter and ask any question that you would like. So today we will see how we import Facebook pages into Excel, To make it interesting, we will use the data of the presidential candidates for United States election. We will also try to see some interesting insights if we have the time, based on the data that we imported and transformed in Excel. We will show you how to do it on multiple pages, because sometimes you want to control more than one page and you want to do a comparison between your own brand and perhaps with competitors. So we'll show you how to do that. And again, go to datachant.com to read more. The technical elements that we will touch are only very briefly to show you the Facebook Graph API that is relevant for our scenarios. And we assume that you know by now the basic of Power Query. And even if you don't know by now and you just follow the steps one by one, you will probably be able to create the same reports and then later on absorb everything and see how you can also take the new acquired knowledge to your own reporting capabilities. Okay, so let's start. So the scenario that we have today is that we have our own Facebook pages and we want to analyze them, and we also have some competitor pages that we want to analyze. So in our example, we will do a deeper analysis and import of data from all the US election candidates. But before we start, let me try to share with you what is the challenge at end. So for example, me as a personal blog, as a private blogger, I have a Facebook page called Data Chant, as well as my blog. So here in this Facebook page, you can see, you can follow ongoing posts and just follow the blogs that I have. But I must admit, I created this page just for demonstration of the Excel scenarios. But imagine that I'm the campaign manager of one of Hillary Clinton, let's say, and I need really to see to measure the engagements. So if I don't use any external solutions and I just go and use Facebook for what I need, Facebook provides some type of reporting as the reporting solution that you see here. This is a built-in reporting that Facebook provides if you manage your Facebook. And you can also use the Facebook APIs to automate some of the information. Just a few comments about the challenge that we have in this type of built-in reporting capability. Basically, so if you have any specific question that you cannot find in this kind of reporting, or if you want to import it into Excel, there is a specific button here that allows you, as you can see here, the export button here on the right. This button allows you to get the data and be able to import it into Excel. But let me show you how challenging the Excel format that you have from this type of manual import from Facebook. So you can see that I have many, many worksheets from Facebook with a lot of data. It is very difficult in this tabular model to be able to get this data and build something very powerful or something that will provide you the insights that you need. Another challenge is all this information is only accessible if you have the admin rights to the Facebook page. Now, if you work in a very big company, perhaps you don't even know who are the guys that manage your Facebook, but you really want to get information and business information about the audience that is active on your brand, even without relationship with the social team. So all the current capabilities, the built-in capabilities by Facebook are quite limiting in what you can achieve. What we will see today, how you can work around the challenges and do something very powerful through Excel. Now, before we'll open Excel and show you what we are going to do, a brief summary or a brief description about the graph, the Facebook Graph API. Okay, so you can go to the support page of Facebook, and let me just open it. This is the tools and support page of Facebook, and there is a tool called Graph API Explorer to the left. I will click on that. And what you will see is a type of a console, a Graph API Explorer, as Facebook call it. And here you can send API calls to Facebook platform to get all kinds of answers. For example, in this case, I'm sending for Facebook a call called me with some fields like ID and name. When I will click on the submit, you can see a JSON response. The format is in a structure called JSON. With my name. Now I can do the same thing, for example, with my blog. My blog is called DataChant blog on Facebook. Okay, and I can just remove even all the fields. And let's see what I get as a response back, just a minute. So you see DataChant and the ID of my page on Facebook. I can do the same also on, for example, Donald Trump. Now I will only see, again, only the public information there. Now Donald Trump page, and let me just show it to you here. If we'll go to Facebook. So you see, this is Donald Trump page, and specifically this specific string called Donald Trump is the Facebook object name for the page entity that the social team and campaign of Donald Trump people guys are managing. So again, what we will need, this specific string to be able to monitor data from that page. So the Graph API, as you saw here in this case, is a way, it's a REST API calls that are using a web request based on the protocol HTTP, where you can just get all kinds of information from Facebook and get it as a response in a JSON format. You have many different entities that you can get, and the thing which is very nice in Excel is that through the Power Query technology, there is a very powerful simplification, so on many cases you will not need to see all the information here. Okay, so let's start with Excel. When we finish today's demo, you will be able to create a report which is similar to the report that you see here. So here, for example, you have the different candidates. I also added a candidate that left the race just to show you how the data is affected by the fact that he left. So that's Marco Rubio. But you see that we have six candidates here, and we can compare their engagement level in Facebook based on different metrics which Facebook call storytellers, and I will discuss it in a minute. You can compare Democrats versus Republicans. You can see the different candidates also over time, and this is, I think, something very amazing that initially when I started to blog about it, I was quite amazed that I have the permissions, and these permissions are actually public, to see all the information also over time. So you can see, for example, here the number of people that are talking about the candidates over time, and I can have a breakdown by each candidate, and I can also see the different countries. Okay, so let's start to see how we will create such a nice report. We start with a blank workbook where I just added a table for all the candidates. I have the candidate's name in column A. In column B, I have the candidate's Facebook name. And again, if you remember, when we, let's just prove it to you, I will take, for example, Senator Sanders. I will copy this text and will go to Facebook. Now, if I will just paste Senator Sanders here and click enter, you will see that I will reach into Bernie Sanders' official Facebook page. So I prepared in advance this table of all the candidates and their associated party, Republican or Democrats. Now let's start with a more basic step. And this step is to get data from a specific candidate. I'll click on the data tab here, and if you are familiar with Excel 2016, you can see that we have the new get and transform section under the data ribbon. This is where Power Query was integrated in Excel 2016. If you are using Power Query add-in in Excel 2010 or 2013, you will have a separate tab, a separate ribbon with all the Power Query functionality. Now, I will click on the new query here, select from other sources, and go to from Facebook. Now, instead of using the object ID, which is me, to reflect information about myself, I will write here Donald Trump. This is the Facebook name for Donald Trump page. Okay, now if I will drill down in the connection drop down, you will probably see that we have here the entity posts. This is the entity that we need to get all of Donald Trump posts. However, when you use this type of selection, you will get an error, so I will skip it and will just skip the none option. Now, another comment about the things that we are doing, these scenarios have some bugs. Most of these bugs are bugs that you can ever walk around and resolve those. So I really recommend if you are trying by yourself to create reports with Facebook and you get into some kind of a challenge, an error, don't stop it there. Go to my blog, try to find it. You can contact me or try check with forums or even do some kind of a trial and error to find some kind of other workarounds, because usually you will find bugs, but there are always some workarounds to get what you need. So in our case, we selected Donald Trump, connection none, and now we will click OK. Now the Power Query editor will be opened. And you can see all the information that Excel and Power Query retrieved from Donald Trump page. Now, and this is where we need to know a bit about the Facebook Graph API, because in our example, for example, let's say we want to read the different posts of Donald Trump. So if I will type here slash posts and click enter, this, at least based on the Graph API, and let me show it to you here. So you can see that on the Facebook official Explorer, Graph API Explorer, when I write Donald Trump slash posts and click submit, you can see that I get a JSON response with all the latest posts by Donald Trump. Now, if I will do it in Excel in Power Query, again, I just changed the text here and added slash posts, and I will now click enter. After several seconds, I will get an error. So this is an example of the errors that you may see if you will just try the direct approach of using Facebook Connector in Excel Power Query. But please don't get this bug intimidate you. Sorry. What you can see here is that Facebook thought that there was some kind of an unknown error. So for me, when I usually get errors from Facebook in Excel in Power Query, I try to move the version of the Graph API and switch the version. So for example, let's try the latest version, which is 2.6. Clicking enter. Suddenly you see, oh, I have a different error now. The error actually tells me the limit parameter should not exceed 100. And you can see in the error details that Power Query sent a request with limit 250 to Facebook, which wasn't something that Facebook accepted. So let me try to work around this bug. And this is, I think, in my own opinion, this is a Microsoft bug, not a Facebook bug. But again, I will add the question mark here in the Graph API URL, and I will add the field limit equal 100. Okay, we just explicitly told Facebook that we are very greedy. We just want to get the data in chunks of 100 records. Clicking OK, and now you suddenly see that all the data is working fine for us. Again, you may think, now this is interesting, I see all of Donald Trump's posts, but I really want to count, for example, the number of shares for each post. So again, you can go to Facebook Graph API support page to try to learn a bit about the API. But to make it faster for you, I can just add here another parameter to the URL. So we will use ampersand, and then we will write fields, and we will explicitly mention the fields that we want. For example, I want the message, I want the created time, which is the date that the post was created and published, and I also want shares, okay? And perhaps even let's add the ID. Now you see that the response from Facebook is not the default one, and suddenly I also have the shares. Okay? Now there is a very nice icon here at the header of shares column, and let's click on that one. And you can see that Power Query identified that there is a field called count under the column shares. This is again because of the JSON format, which is a nested format that Power Query got from Facebook. Let's click OK. And you see that the shares column was transformed into shares.count column, and now we have the shares of each of the posts by Donald Trump. Now, if, for example, we want to load this information to Excel, let's just load it. And we will use the data model just for the example here. Now you see on the right side, the workbook queries is appearing, and you see how many rows we are loading from Donald Trump page. So we got 2,658 different posts. We can also go now and insert, for example, a pivot table. So let's take, for example, the IDs into the values. So you see this is the number of IDs, and we can also take the created time to rows, and you see the different posts that were done on every day by Donald Trump and also by our. Now again, this is relatively once you have this data in Excel, it's relatively straightforward. So now you have every row is a post with its shares. But I want to show you something more interesting about Facebook Graph API and your abilities to get information which is more interesting. Okay, I'm deleting this information. Sorry for that, just a second. We have many rows here, let's just delete everything. Never mind. So we'll do everything again. This time, instead of using the posts in the Graph API, we will use another specific endpoint in the Graph API called Insights. Basically, as you saw earlier, when I show you my own insight page of my site, you saw all the built-in information that Facebook provides is basically can be extended by any third party that want to develop monitoring solution for Facebook.
Just a
and
second.
The way to retrieve.
Yep, sir. Just a second. I accidentally shared the polls with people instead of showing your screen. So, that people.
Oh, so we need phones to start from screen.
Yeah, I managed to. let's see now if we should. Sorry about that, people. Where did it go? typically I can't find it back again. There we go. Okay, sorry about that. You can continue, Gil.
Okay, so sorry guys for that. I didn't see anything in the chat, sorry. The first demo that I've just showed you was based on the ability to use the Graph API in the Graph API by Facebook. And what we did is to take Donald Trump page and importing all the posts by Donald Trump. Now, what we are going to do now is to do something more interesting, which is to use Donald Trump page and based on the endpoint called Insights by the Graph API. This one is more powerful in the way to get data from pages and also from multiple pages and to some extent also pages that you don't control. So just to show you what we will going to do now in Excel, I will do it first on the Graph API Explorer. So you can see when I downgraded the version of the Graph API from version 2.6 to version 2.3, I got information here, a JSON structure, which is based on Donald Trump page. And you see that I have, for example, a metric called page fans country, which shows you for each country how many users like Donald Trump page. Okay, and this, you see, we have 3 days of data here. Now we also have another interesting metric, which is called page storyteller by country. This is even more interesting metric than the previous one, because in this metric in Facebook Graph API, you can get information about the storytellers. Sorry. The storytellers is a metric known by Facebook which accumulate data, a combination of data from the people on Facebook that liked your pages, commented about your pages, shared posts. Everyone who is active and using your brand on Facebook, this is an aggregator that gets all their activity and measure it based on unique users. So what we are going to do now is to import this information inside Excel. Okay, so we have this worksheet where, as you can see, we have on this specific table, and let me just open it again to delete the data that we created from the previous demo that you didn't see. But you can see here that we have the table of all the candidates. Now we will go again to Facebook. to the Facebook connector in Power Query Excel. So I'm clicking new query in the data ribbon from other sources, and I will select here from Facebook. Now, instead of me, I will write here Donald Trump and click OK. The query editor opens and I will change here the version to 3 and we'll add slash insights. Now you can see that I got all the public metrics that I can take from Donald Trump. Again, only the public ones. Just to show you, if you will use version 2.2, eventually this also works, but we will see later how perhaps to some scenarios this may fail. So we will want to focus now on the metric page storytellers by country. Okay, and also let's just get the daily information, because this is what we want to create the report in this demo. Now you see that we have a lot of textual columns that are not really helpful for us. And the most important thing that we need here is in the values columns here. So we can click on the choose columns on the home ribbon, and we can select only the values columns. And click OK in this dialog. Now we got the values column, and you see the expand icon next to the header of values. We will click on that and uncheck use original column name as prefix and click OK. Now you see that we now have a record for 4 different days. And everything, all this data comes from Donald Trump. Let's expand the value column. Now you see that we got all the different countries as fields. To make it a bit easier, I will just switch between the two columns. So I'm dragging and dropping end time to the beginning. It's better that I will start with the time and then with the record. Now, if you remember when we just started this demonstration, I told you that we have overtime data, even though we don't control the page itself. So the trick to achieve that is to go again to the source in the applied steps and right here on the URL that you use for the Graph API, I will use a question mark with the field since equal 2016 and also the date. Let's start with the beginning of March and also the first of that month. Okay, so we have since 2016 March the first, and we'll click enter. And now if you will go back to the reordered columns, suddenly you see something much more promising. You can see that I have all the data that I asked for. Again, if we will try to be greedy and we'll change this year to 2015 and go to the last step, you will see that Facebook will provide an error for us. We were too greedy in this report. We will need to ask for data. In my experience, you need to ask at least for 2 months. 2 months of data is okay, but more than 2 months of data is probably challenging. You will get errors. So again, let's change it back to 2016. Just a minute. Click enter. Go back in applied steps to the right to the last step. And now you see the second column called value. There is the expand button. I can click on that. Click OK. And now I have all the countries that I asked for. The next transformation is something that I really like. It is called the pivot or unpivot experience. Sorry, the unpivot experience, where I can select all the columns here, because you can see we have different countries. All the countries are the same type of information, and we really need to transform this table into into three columns: the end time or the created time for the specific measurement, the country, and how many storytellers we have for that country for that specific time. So I can select all the columns and right click on them while all of these columns are selected, and click the pivot columns. Well, since you see we have many countries here, I can do instead something, and it is to right click on the columns that we don't want to perform the unpivot, which is the end time in this case, and click on the unpivot other columns option here. And you see now that I have the information that I wanted. I can also, let's change the name of the columns to time, to country, and also we will use here storytellers. These are the number of different users that are active on Facebook. They like posts by Donald Trump. They tag links from Donald Trump. They do many things on the Facebook that is related to Donald Trump, and we just call this column storytellers. Now we can change the type of this column to whole number, and we can now close and load this information, and let's just load it into the data model by selecting only create connection and add this data to the data model, and we click load here. And now again, Power Query gets all the information, and we can go and create. Let's create a pivot chart now, just to see how it looks like. I'm creating a pivot chart. I will just take the time to the axis categories and the storyteller to the values, and you can see in this case how many shares, likes, all the storytelling activity of Donald Trump page over time. Now the interesting thing is that we want to make it on all the different candidates, right? So there are several approaches to that. One can think that he can manually copy the query and just change Donald Trump with the other names that you have here. But today I want to show you a very cool functionality by Power Query, which is to use functions in Power Query in order to automate your work and to avoid doing something multiple times. So let's delete this pivot chart, and we'll go again to the original query that we've just created, and let's duplicate it. I right clicked on the pane to duplicate the query. You can also see here on the left pane in the editor all the queries that I have. Okay, and now if we will go to the advanced editor, you can see that I have a Donald Trump here in the text. Now again, if you didn't open the advanced editor before, this is fine. Just a very quick background. So Power Query performs different transformation, which you can see to the right, but the inner workings of the engine is to create from all your transformation in the UI a script which is used for the engine to do the transformation. You can access the script through the advanced editor command here, and Every line that you see in this script was a step that we performed through the UI. You can also manipulate it through this screen. The language is called also M, and you can read about it on many different resources now on the web. So again, what we need to do is just to be able to dynamically change Donald Trump to the page that we want to get. To do that, we will just add the following. I'm opening a parenthesis here and adding Facebook page inside the parenthesis and use the sign equal greater than. Now this operation will turn this query into a function. Now when I have a function with a parameter called Facebook page, I can copy this parameter instead of Donald Trump. Now since this is a dynamic parameter, I just need to concatenate it into the string like this. So now you see that we are creating a dynamic URL of the Facebook Graph API instead of Donald Trump with the parameter that will be provided through Facebook page attribute, and I'm using the ampersands to be able to concatenate the string itself. Now by clicking done, you will see that Power Query detected our work and now it treats it as a function. Now we can go here to the properties pane, and in the name edit box we will just give it some proper name, like let's write get storytellers as a function name for the specific query that we did. Now something important, and this is just a tip for you, usually when I switch my transformation from a query to a function, I keep the original query. As you see here, query one was the original one, we duplicated it and we switch it into a function, but we still want to keep the original one, because sometimes if you want to change the function, the current implementation doesn't allow you to do that through the UI. The UI doesn't show you all the table of the data and the steps are hidden from the applied steps. You cannot really manipulate it unless you open the advanced editor and do the changes from this edit box. So the only way to do that is really to keep the original query as we did here, and then if we want to perform additional changes, we can do the changes and then convert again the query one into the function that we need. Okay, so now again we have a function that gets a page. I have a typo here, so let's also fix it. So we have a page, and this function gets the insights from that page of all the storytellers. Okay, now let's close this window here. And you can see that the storytellers, get storytellers, was added to the workbook queries. Now let's take the table that we created in advance with all the US election candidates, and we will go again to the data ribbon and click on the from table button. You see the from table, this is the second button that we have in the get and transform section. This button allows us to import data from the current workbook. So after clicking it, you see again the query editor opens up and we have the different candidates on the table here. As you remember, the Facebook page column is the place where we added all the different entities by Facebook that allows you to get information for each one of the candidates. Now we will go to the add column ribbon and click on the add custom column. But just a second before we do that, I open again the queries just to remind me of the name get storytellers. This is the function that we created earlier, and now we are building the candidates query. So I will click on the add column, add custom column, and inside this box I will type here the name of the function that we created, which was get story get storytellers. Now I'm calling the information in the second column, Facebook page, as the parameter to that function. Closing the argument with the parentheses and clicking OK. Yeah, now you see I have a warning, information is required about data privacy. This is again because of the fact that we are now meshing up between our current workbook data from the table of the candidates and also with Facebook Graph API, which is a public site. So in our case, what we can do is click continue and just state to Excel that the current workbook is public. This is, there is nothing personal or nothing which is on the enterprise level important for us that we need to keep and not to avoid sending it to Facebook Graph API. So we just set it to public and click save. Another tip that I can provide you, and this is again due to some bug that it's probably not a bug but a bad design by Microsoft, is that in a second you will get another privacy error. So to avoid that, you can go also to File, Options and Settings, Query Options, and inside Query Options dialog you go to the Privacy section under Current Workbook, and you change the fast combine to ignore the privacy levels and potentially improve performance. By doing that, you are just setting the privacy of the specific workbook, so you don't need to worry about doing something that will violate some privacy policies for your organization. It's only for this specific workbook that only has public information anyway. So I will click OK here, and now you can see that for each one of the US presidential candidates, I have different tables. Let's click on the expand button and uncheck the user original column name as prefix. And you see that now all the data was expanded. I can also remove the Facebook page, which is not longer needed. This is a technical data that was only needed to address to get the official Facebook page name to the Graph API call, so we can delete the second column. And again, since we use the function doesn't remember the format of storytellers, so I will go to data type any and change it into whole number. And also let's go to the time and change the time into a daytime time zone. And now we can go to close and load to, and get all this information into Excel. Let's just do that. Now you see that we got 10,061 rows from all the data set that we have, and we can go now and let's just show you the type of data that we just collected. So I will go to the Insert tab in Excel, and I'll select the pivot chart, and I will make sure that I'm using data model. In previous versions of Excel, you will probably use Power Pivot in this area, or you can, by the way, also load the data directly to the worksheet. So there are different scenarios how you can use this data in Excel, but let's use the 2016 option, which is by selecting the default use this workbook's data model. We'll click OK. And now I can go, let's close the Power Query workbook queries pane, and just use the pivot chart fields. And again, I can see, for example, let's take the party, put the party on the axis and the story on the values. And now you can see how many storytellers you have by the Republicans versus the Democrats. For example, let's create another chart. Again, I'll go to the pivot chart, and now let's take the time now into consideration. Now you can see also the automatic grouping of the time by Excel. Excel automatically detected that that was a time field, so it detected the month here, and I can also drag the storytellers. Now you can see that I also can see the data, and let's also drag the candidates to the legend. Let's change also the format to something more absorbable. We'll change it, the chart type into stacked column. And that's it. Now you see that we have all the different candidates, over time, which is quite powerful. There are many different reporting capabilities or visuals that you can use. You can also use this data in Power BI to get what you want. Just to demonstrate some interesting insights, let's also filter, for example, all the information here and just keep only Marco Rubio to show how Marco Rubio was affected by the fact that he left the race. So again, you can see in a very interesting way how data speaks the truth. So probably around mid-March was the time that Marco Rubio left the race. So you can see that. And just to give you another example, let's use country information. So for example, let's see how something that happened in the world could affect people that will talk about the different candidates. So for example, we had the terrible terror attack in Brussels. Let's see if people at Belgium are talking about the different candidates much more on the time of the attack or just after the attack had happened. So we will, let's use the same chart. We will take the chart and add also the country information in the legend instead of the candidates. Now we have the different countries here, and we can also go and just decide to filter by Belgium. And again, you can see on the 23rd of March, there is a high increase of storytellers in Belgium that are mentioning the different candidates, the US candidates. So again, this is a very interesting point to see how US politics affect people globally when there is something like a global threat. So that's it. I think the time is close to up. If you have any questions, feel free to call me. I deeply apologize for the first demo that we couldn't share with you, but I will be glad to answer any question that you have following this session. And please follow my blog, datachant.com. All the things that I showed you is step by step shared in these blogs with a walkthrough that you will be able to follow even if you don't have any Power Query experience. Okay. So.
Yes, thank you, Gil. Thanks everyone for coming. Not a lot of questions, but Donald Parrish says, great Facebook info, I'd gotten stuck before. So again, thank you, Gil, and thanks everyone for coming. And if you haven't done so before, check out sqlpass.org as well.
Okay, bye everyone.
And yes, somebody says here, we saw both demos, only the full screen was for about a minute. This was awesome. Does this work in Power BI Online?
Of course. It works, and I also add a recent blog that shows how to get the different posts and to create a word cloud out of it. So please follow my blog. You will see many powerful tutorials that you can achieve.
Yeah, so that's datachant.org.com, yeah?
Yes.
Yes, and the recording will be made available either tonight or tomorrow. So yes, it will be available. I think we'll wrap it up there. Thank you, everybody, and thank you, Gil.
Thank you.